In this video, I'm going to show you how to update your theme forest, your Codecanyon themes and plugins that you may have purchased and added to your website. Now, the problem with buying themes or plugins from theme forest, well, it's theme forest and Codecanyon. The problem with buying it from them is there's no real easy way or obviously easy way of updating them. So when you download the theme or the plugin, you add it to your WordPress site, it doesn't automatically tell you when there's an update. You click a button and it updates. And people don't realize that Envato, who owns ThemeForest and Codecanyon, has actually made a very easy way to do this, but it's not well publicized. So I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. And by following the instructions in this video, you will be able to update your ThemeForest themes, your Codecanyon plugins, all automatically. When there's an update, you'll be able to do it all automatically from within WordPress. So Envato has made something called the Envato Toolkit. And what we first need to do is download and install this Envato Toolkit. Now, if they wanted to make it easy for you, they'd put a nice big link somewhere on their site, but I've never found that. So if you went to Google and you typed Envato Toolkit, you will eventually find it. So I'm going to put a link on where to download this down below. If you're watching this on YouTube or if you're on my website, there'll be a download link below. It's essentially just a plugin. So if you did that search, you would come right here to, and it looks very technical, it's called GitHub. And this is where most developers of anything, they store all their code. So it's very geeky, all right? But if you did find this page and you scroll down a bit, there's all this information about it. It's actually was renamed to Envato Market instead of Envato Toolkit. And when you scroll down, here it says installation, and you'll find the actual download link. So I'm going to give you a direct link to this download. If Envato changes that, just notify me and I'll update the link. And all it says is to download and install it like you would any other plugin. So we're going to do that. Let's go ahead and do that right now, as a matter of fact. So I'm going to log into a WordPress site here. I'm on the dashboard. I'm just going to go to add new. It's just your typical plugin installation. I'm going to click upload plugin. And I've already downloaded it. So I'm going to just drag and drop it right there. I'm going to click install now. And then I'm going to go ahead and then click on Activate Plugin. And now we have this new link right here. It says Envato Market. Now, the prior method of doing this was with a plugin called the Envato Toolkit. And it was a little more simple to use. It would involve logging in and creating some kind of a key. You copy and paste it. And they've changed that. Now it's called Envato Market. And I'm sure there's some business reasons why they've done that. All we have to do now is follow the instructions right here to get it connected to our ThemeForest account or our Envato account. So all we have to do is go here, scroll down, and we need to click on this link that says generate a personal token. So I'm going to go ahead and open that in this tab here. So I'm already logged in. If you are not, it's going to ask you for your login. So you would just put in your ThemeForest login, if that's what you use for purchasing, or your Codecanyon login. A lot of times it's the same for both, and that's how it is for me. So I'm already logged in, and it's going to be at this screen that says create a token. Now all we need to do is create a token and give it some silly name. So I'm going to name it WPCrafter. It doesn't, I think, really matter at all. It just says pick something cool, short, and catchy. And then there's these permissions that are going to be given to this token name. Now, I would not adjust any. That link already pre-filled it out in the ones that are needed in order to enable automatic updates for you. And then go ahead and check this box that says I've read and I understood the and agree to the terms and conditions, whatever. Click on create token. And then it's going to go ahead and this green screen's going to pop up and it's going to give you your API key, which all you need to do is highlight and copy. So I'm going to copy that into my clipboard. And then I'm going to check this box to confirm that I did put it in my clipboard. And then I'm going to click on this white button here that says got it. Okay, so now you have this API key in your clipboard. You might want to save that on a notepad someplace if you're using your purchased products on other websites so that you don't have to keep creating API keys. You've got it now. Okay, so I'm going to go back to my WordPress site and I'm going to just paste it in here. And then I'm going to click on Save Changes. Okay, so now that I have saved my changes, it is showing me the different themes and plugins that I have purchased on this account. Now, if I had, say for instance, right here, I have the Salient theme that I've purchased. If that was the theme that was installed on this website and it noticed there was an older version, it would give me an option to update it. But right here, you can see I can basically click on the install button for any of these themes that I've purchased before and it will install it for you. And this is actually an easier method to install a purchased theme or plugin that you have from Envato, is just to do it through the Envato Market plugin. And I think that's kind of what they're going after, is making it a lot simpler and more easy for you. So when I scroll down here, these are a bunch of the themes that I have purchased. Let's go on plugins. I haven't purchased a lot of different plugins, just a very few. And then there's also this settings tab where you can change that API key that you just generated. And this is going to be such an easy way for you to now keep your purchased themes and plugins that you purchased from ThemeForest and Codecanyon fully updated. And one last thing, I know I've interchangeably said Envato, ThemeForest, Codecanyon. Let me go back over to ThemeForest right here. This is ThemeForest's website. Now, ThemeForest is owned by a company called Envato, and Envato owns ThemeForest, Codecanyon, and all these other sites that you see listed here at the top. So if you have a login for ThemeForest, it's going to work on all of these different sites that they own. It's their family of sites where you can purchase software, you can purchase video, stock video and audio, graphics, a whole bunch of things you can purchase from them. So when I'm saying ThemeForest or Codecanyon, I'm really just talking about using your Envato login. And one last thing, if you are going to purchase anything from ThemeForest or Codecanyon, head on over to my website and click on the recommended tab, and I've got a link that will take you over there. When you do purchase, after having clicked on my link, they give me a couple dollars, and what's nice about that is I can use that to purchase things that I could then review for you. Well, that's it for today's video. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it in the comment section down below. Please also give me a thumbs up on YouTube. That really helps me out. And if you haven't subscribed yet to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button. That also helps me out. Now, I don't want you to ever leave empty-handed, and that's why I've put together a free video course just for my subscribers called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success. Now, if you would like free access to that course, just go ahead and click right here on the right. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.